What's up guys, welcome to another video. Please hit that like and subscribe button and welcome to Greedy Smoothies. So today is my last video of 2017. I'm really excited because today is the first time I've ever done an in-depth review of a product. So I'm going to be reviewing the Nike Air Zoom Pegasus 34s. I've run 200 miles in these shoes, which is crazy. So a few months ago, I unboxed these shoes and I did a first impressions review, and I had a harsh review on these shoes. The insole was super hard. I felt like I was running on bricks the first few runs. Felt like an eternity whenever I went on a run because my feet hurt so bad. And I'm happy to say that after 200 miles, my review has changed with these shoes. The insole has softened out a lot. My runs just feel so great. I haven't had a single injury with this shoe, which is amazing. I can bring these shoes on almost any terrain when I'm training at home. I know some people have specific shoes for specific terrain, but these shoes can pretty much do any terrain, which is amazing. They can do sand, grass, roads, a lot of terrain. I'm just gonna do the review. I'm gonna talk about what I like and dislike about these shoes. First up, I love the durability on the waffle cones, and I'll show you what I mean. Here's my pair of 33s. I've run 200 miles on these also. It's about the exact same amount of miles I have on the 34s. Here is the 33s, and here's the 34s. As you can see on the 33s, some of the waffle cone is completely worn out, or almost completely worn out, especially in the toe area. There's a ton of waffle cone on the bottom. That's the one that runs on my toes. Here's the 34s. I'm still a toe runner. As you can see, only these two waffle cones are almost completely worn out, but most of them are still like halfway full or three quarters full, which is crazy. Next up, I'm gonna talk about the outside of the 34s and 33s, like comparing them. So here you have the 33s. As you can see, outside the shoe is pretty good. The biggest problem I have with the 33s is just not stable. Sometimes I felt like the outside was super stiff, sometimes it was super soft. It was just really frustrating. I felt like with the 34s, Nike really focused on that. As you can tell, a lot of the outside of the shoe is smooth. They made these holes bigger, which let more air into your foot. I love how they have this thing wrapped around the heel, so it makes it feel more stable around your foot. Next up, I got some bright colored shoes, and I was worried that if I ever got these shoes dirty, be super visible. As you can tell, it is actually not that visible that they are dirty, because usually if you have light colored shoes, all the stains are super visible. Moving on to the things I dislike about the 34s. There are tons of little dots all over the heel of my shoe, and that's from the heel of my socks. These little dots come off my sock and just cling to the heel of the shoe. It drives me crazy because my foot feels super itchy all the time in the heels because there's so much of the dots that come off your socks. I've never had a problem with any other shoes. Also, you guys have noticed the Nike running thing? Some of the letters are peeled off. That is not okay. It used to say Nike running, and now you can't really tell what it says. My last complaint, some of you may have liked this and some may not. On the 33s, it had the half and half design going like that. The 34s, the half and half goes this way, you know? I liked it when it went like that on the 33s better than the 34s, which is like this with the colors. That's my review, the Nike Air Zoom Pegasus 34s. I definitely consider these a runner's classic. The heel is a bit of a problem. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please leave a like and subscribe.